Namaskar friends, I Poonam Dogra on the behalf of Vichitra Enterprises welcomes you all and hope you are doing great. So friends, in our last two videos, we covered UPS, which is an emergency device used whenever your power cut happens or your power failure happens. But did you notice that UPS is not storing any electrical energy? UPS just converting AC into DC, DC into AC, and doing power conditioning. So from where we are getting this 1 hour, 2 hour energy backup? From batteries. Batteries are storage devices, and friends, here to note that other than batteries, there are many storage devices like flywheels, fuel cells, and ultra capacitor, etc. But we are covering batteries because these are one of the most important technologies or storage devices, because future technologies like solar, electric vehicles, and UPS, etc., are based on batteries. So we will cover batteries, and as it's a vast topic, then video will be covered in more parts. So stay connected. Let's check out.
When batteries were developed in 18th century, this term battery was borrowed from military. Now the term battery means a device which is a combination of multiple cells. Like a number of cells are being combined to make a device which is called battery. Now every storage devices stores energy in one form of energy and convert it back to electrical energy whenever required. So batteries stores this energy in the form of chemical energy and convert it. So firstly, electrical energy is being converted into chemical energy and stored in the batteries, and again this chemical energy is being converted into electrical energy whenever required. Friends, one thing to remember here is that only DC can be stored in batteries. AC form of electrical energy, which comes to our home from electrical departments or distributing company, cannot be stored in batteries. That is why we require some conversion devices like rectifier, chargers, inverters to convert AC into DC or DC into AC. Now, unit of battery or battery capacity rating is done in ampere hours. Now next, coming to the construction of batteries, it has two electrodes. One is positive, which is called anode, and the second one is negative, cathode, and some solution in between, which is called electrolyte. This will carry the charge in between the electrodes. Friends, we will not go very deep into this construction. I gave you this overview only to make a picture of components of batteries in your mind, and also the type of material used for electrolyte and electrodes makes the only difference between different kinds of batteries. On right side, we can see symbol used for batteries. The lower one is for one cell and the upper one is for combination of cells. Coming to the types of batteries, batteries are divided into two general groups, primary batteries and secondary batteries. Now friends, think of batteries you use for your wall clock, table clock and remote controls, etc., which can be used only once, are primary batteries. Its example are dry cells, alkaline batteries. A picture of primary batteries is shown in right side. Batteries like which we use in our mobiles, in laptop, in inverters, etc., are secondary batteries, which can be reused, recharged after every complete discharge. So secondary batteries are more important, more focused, and it has more applications. So we will discuss about secondary batteries. Now here is a chart showing different types of rechargeable batteries like lead acid, nickel cadmium, lithium ion and their subparts. There is a lot to know about rechargeable batteries, their types, their applications, their differences. So we will learn all of this in our next video. Here I must say that the coming videos are more important. We'll cover more about batteries, about mainstream batteries. So stay connected. I hope you got something about batteries and how you find this video. Please give your reviews and queries in the comment section below. Finally, it's time to say bye-bye. Thank you, friends. Thank you for watching. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Thank you.